Mayurbhanj district is one of the 30 districts in Odisha state in eastern India. It is the central region of Odisha, expanding 10,418 square kilometers, having more than 2.5 million population as per the census 2011. It has 59% of the tribal population, of whom more than 60% of the people live in rural communities. Mayurbhanj has a literacy rate of 63.17%. Having chosen three remote gram panchayats such as Brahmugaon, Sorisupal and Chakiri of Bangriposi block of Mayurbhanj, after the field assessment and consultations with stakeholders of different levels, Balasore Social Service Society launched the project called SPRED, which stands for Sustainable and Participatory Rural Empowerment through Agri-based Livelihood Development, supported and funded by the esteemed organization Manos Unidas of Spain in 2017 March. BSSS took a challenge to toil for these backward tribal communities in 45 villages scattered around hills and forests, having less facilities of communication and transportation, holding hands with them and showing the way ahead to progress.
The project aimed to address food insecurity of the target communities by increasing availability and improving access to food through increased agricultural productivity, innovative water conservation methods, and enhanced income generation opportunities. The project strategy was to invest significantly in community mobilization and capacity building to adopt improved farming practices, introduce and strengthen alternative off-farm livelihood options, creative and innovative water conservation methods, and improving governance at the village level. Throughout all the activities, the project fostered partnership and convergence with government and other local institutions, prioritizing active community participation, particularly of women. Having selected a team of vibrant staff, the first task was to orient and motivate the communities to realize the need and necessity of change and progress, to awake them from their easy lifestyle of being content with some food to just sustain them was a tough and difficult task. Baseline survey helped them to have strong and clear picture of the status of the community. A span of a year and more, BSSS team traveled through each and every village, motivating them, sharing the purpose of the intervention and expected changes in the community, storming and forming them into groups for the collective and effective participation and sustainable progress. Today, there are 45 farmer clubs and 49 active women self-help groups closely working with the BSSS intervention.
The first objective of the intervention was to strengthen the capacity of the targeted households to secure their livelihood and to increase their productivity. Though agriculture is their main source of livelihood, it does not sustain them even for 6 months of the year. The major reasons of the same are many. Most of their cultivation is limited to kharif season only, just a survival level farming, lack of irrigation facilities, lack of stress-tolerant varieties of seeds, lack of availability of quality seeds at the right time, lack of secondary livelihood options, lack of knowledge of improved agricultural practices, gradual erosion of soil, infertile and unused land, too much of cultural festivals, and lack of motivation. All these seriously affect the production and make them mostly food insecure. BSSS started to train them village and cluster levels on the improved agricultural practices along with strengthening their own good traditional practices. It gave intensive training on paddy cultivation such as summer ploughing, green manure, soil test, seed cleaning, seed treatment, nursery bed preparation, nursery management, seedling treatment, line transplanting, water management, training on integrated pest management, training on integrated nutrient management, and training on post-harvest management.
BSSS supported them quality seeds, tolerant paddy seeds like Swarna Sub 1 and Bina 11, which are flood tolerant varieties, and Sahabhagi, which is drought tolerant, and also high yielding varieties like DRR 42, DRR 44, CO 51, etc. BSSS also supported them with traditional seeds, which are the choices of the farmers themselves, like the Kalachampa, Lalat, Nabeen, Pooja, and Jhapri. The team accompanied the farmers in implementing the knowledge gained and making successful models in different areas. Though they were reluctant to change the traditional way of farming, seeing the changes of those who took initiative, many of the farmers were encouraged to replicate the good practices. After 3 years of constant support and guidance, today there has been a very significant progress, not only in the production but also in their attitude and interest of improving their soil livelihood option. The baseline showed an average production of paddy as 9.5 quintal per acre, which has grown gradually over 3 years of time and reached 17 to 23 quintal acre, which is a huge difference and great success. Today, we can also see a good number of farmers are cultivating paddy in the rabi season by the support of the pump sets from the hub and other natural and government-linked irrigation facilities. Data shows that more than 50% of the beneficiary farmers are following line transplantation with visible results from them.
BSSS has supported them with a quantity of 237 quintal quality paddy seeds for 1,429 farmers in 1,185 acres over the 3 years by the project. They also have been introduced and strengthened different pulses and cash crops, especially for the rabi season, which was not a time of cultivation for them. They always complain that there are no irrigation facilities and so rabi cultivation is not possible in their area. After the demo fields and different training programs, today they cultivate different pulses like green gram, black gram, groundnut, green peas, arum, yam, wheat, mustard, etc., making use of the barren land for ginger and turmeric cultivation, which don't need much irrigation, was completely a new thing they learnt and began practicing, which also contribute to their income. Though BSSS supported them with a total of 3,520 for 9 farmers clubs, 9 SHGs and 93 individual, they are motivated to preserve the seeds for the future and to share them with others in need.
Promotion of kitchen garden is another successful story to be told, because from 13% of the families who were self-sufficient with vegetables, today more than 35% of them are cultivating sufficient vegetables for their consumption, and also some of them selling in their local market and making a good income out of it. 423 households and 5 SHGs were given good quality of seeds along with the training for innovative cultivation. Integrated Farming System, IFS, was promoted in all the villages to have varieties of livelihood options generating income around the year. So more than 25 small and big IFS models were established by the farmers with the support of the BSSS, which they learned how to make use of paddy of their own land in a proper way with the chicks, cow, fish, vegetables, fruit trees, paddy, pulses and different cash crops in different seasons. They were also taught to recycle the waste from the field to organic manure. Different types of biocompost were introduced to the communities like Nadef, vermicompost, azolla, etc.
aiming at the food security and economic stability of the community, BSSS has not forgotten to improve the health condition of the livestock of the area through vaccination and training. It is their second livelihood which is sustainable. Through training and input support like goats, chicks and pigs, BSSS has strengthened the income of a good number of the families. BSSS supported with 2,100 chicks for 210 members of SHG, 275 goats for 140 SHG members and 20 pigs for 4 SHG groups, both through the project and government linkages. The machinery hubs of the farmers' clubs have taught them to make their work easier, effective and manage time in a better way. They started using weeder in between the line transplantation to remove the weeds as well as to break the roots to multiply its strength, sprayer, pump sets for irrigation, seed drills and plough, which are managed by the farmers' clubs with minimum contribution from the members for its maintenance. More than 70% of the households are now using one or the other machinery items, either from the hub or what they receive through the linkage with government departments.
A significant and sustainable transformation of the people of the area is the establishment of a good linkage with many of the government departments, especially those related with the agriculture and livelihood like Krishi Vigyan Kendra, KVK, Veterinary Department, Agriculture and Horticulture Department, Fishery Department, Soil and Water Conservation Department, NABARD, whose officers are now in touch with the lead farmers and local leaders. Our aim is to create a strong linkage of the farmer clubs and self-help groups with these departments, where the people will be able to tap maximum benefit from government. Participatory Learning and Action, PLA, and its recommendations submitted every year in Pali Sabha and Gram Sabha will enable both the village community and the PRI members to know their rights and duties well for the fair implementation of the government programs.
If one could ask me what could be the most significant change that the spread intervention has brought about to the lives of the people in Bangriposi block, I would answer, it is the change in the lives of women folk of the area who were considered to be living in the four walls of their house doing the household works. Though it was a tough job to bring about a change in the culture and tradition, today BSSS has 49 SHGs where 541 women are actively participating in the developmental process. Though they may not be able to read and write, they are holding meetings, participating in the decision-making process. They have their own collections. They avail bank loans by themselves traveling more than 20 kilometers to bank. A good number of groups are generating a good income by their family by different kind of income generation activities like group cultivation of paddy, pulses, cash crops, mushroom, phenyl preparation, incense stick making, soft drinks and sweets preparation, pickles and sauce preparation, collective care of chicks, goats and pigs rearing, along with the traditional activities like sal leaves collection for plates, etc. They were given motivation and a first-hand experience with successful groups and interventions in different places through exposure visits. According to the database of the income expenditure of the IGP program, around ₹15,37,230 is the net profit calculated from 565 households, mostly from the members of farmers' clubs and SHGs over the 3 years of project implementation. Today, women are becoming more active, more motivated and hardworking for a better life with dignity than the men of the area who spend much time on drinking and celebrating their lives unproductive.
exploring possibilities of creative and innovative water conservation methods for a better natural resource management was the second objective towards which there was a study carried out by the Foundation for Ecological Studies, FES, who introduced a software called GeoODK Collect, through which we can identify area with groundwater and water recharging area. It would help the farmers to locate possible water sources in their area. Since it was not a satisfactory study conducted, another research agency, Action for Food Production, AFPRO, was consulted, who carried out a research study of the area and submitted recommendations for further possibilities. Accordingly, people were given training on different techniques on water harvesting and soil management. BSSS implemented some selected recommendation to improve the water recharging of the area and to block soil erosion, such as 30-40 models, 5% models, gully plugs, trenches and renovation of the existing water bodies, along with 25 structures in 7 village farmers themselves replicated a few structures in their land, by which 110 acres of land is estimated to profit out it in the nearby future. There are good examples of success stories already, of which the water structures help them to cultivate more and protect their land.
Through development of different IEC materials, wall painting, video shows, awareness programs and trainings, BSS tried to disseminated information on different income generation program, agricultural interventions, government schemes and entitlements. Knowledge is power, it sustains. It is by knowledge and attitudinal change, many have come out of their old ways to a new world of progress and change. BSSS too joined with the people through their culture and different celebrations, motivating them with values and moral for good and happy life. Still, they need to strive, need to grow. There are a good number of people whose life is not affected by this intervention, who stayed away from the active participation. The changes are with the 40 to 50% of the households who traveled along with BSSS for the last 3 years. People still needs our helping hands to sustain the activities because change is gradual, especially in the tribal communities. Continuous education and inspiration would bring the communities to the mainstream where they will experience the real progress.
On behalf of the people of Bangri Kosi, Balasore Social Service Society conveys a big thanks to the esteemed agency Manos Unidas of Spain, who made it possible by their valuable support and guidance. It is their love and care for the humanity that enables spread to spread its fragrance of change and progress in the remote areas of Mayurbhanj. BSSS will continue to travel as it is for the last 27 years, taking its mission of being a powerful catalyst among the poor and needy, bringing smile to millions of people in the land of Odisha.